Good morning, family.
Good morning.
And I want to be able to tell you that I am so excited to see so many of you here today talking about something that is near and dear to me. We have an epidemic going on in our community, and I'm scared. This morning, we're going to get started on a really good project.
My collaborations with HAAFII, that has really taught me about how do we disseminate this, how do we really make a difference in the community. We do a lot of research, but you know, how much of it really hits home. And when I started talking to people a little bit about this project, they said, oh no, there's no increase in STIs and STDs for older people, that's not happening. But you know, here clearly we see that there's been an increase for adults over the age of 65 with chlamydia, syphilis, gonorrhea, and also HIV. So using Dr. Jones's model of community partnerships, particularly academic community partnerships, this is what we wanted to do in sort of really having a tied-in circle of influence to look at how do we engage the community and academic researchers. And this was sort of the theoretical model of how we proceeded forward with this project. So there were 45 women from the community, African-American women in age ranges 50 to 75. We had blind raters who did not know, I mean, everybody was anonymous. We gave these women names of flowers, and so we made sure that they did not say their name, do not say your name, because we did not want their identity to be revealed. And these were the questions that, as the planning group team, we decided would be important to ask. So the first question was, how, you know, comfortable do you feel discussing sexual practices with your physician? Second question was, how, you know, do women you know or women like you have a conversation about the use of protection with their partners? And then the third question was, you know, is this conversation, do you have this conversation about sex with friends, family, partners? Like, how often is this conversation happening? Do you feel in your community there are access to these STI, STD prevention services? Not once you have the STI, STD, but prior to that. So we wanted to calculate each unique response to the question, and that's exactly what we did. So as you see, probably it's pretty close, but the highest response that we saw that the women said was that they didn't feel comfortable discussing sex with their physician, and also they didn't feel that their physician felt comfortable discussing sex with them. So it was this sort of bi-directional discomfort, and a lot of that came with gender, with race, and just culture, or, you know, how does this topic even get brought up? And for the most part, that rapport and really being able to trust the doctor was one of the biggest barriers for really being able to engage in this conversation. This was question two about how, whether or not women felt comfortable having conversations about the use of protection with their partners. And for the most part, the answer was no, because you can see that the first three responses were basically no, but for different reasons. And so, and then some of the responses, it was almost a split, because some of the women in the group said, yeah, no, women are having these conversations with their partners. You know, they're comfortable if, you know, if they've been together a while, they feel like they're wise enough to have this conversation. And particularly if they themselves had already acquired an STI or STD, that made them more sort of ready to say, I'm okay with having this conversation now, you know, because I've learned from previous experience. But, you know, I thought this was interesting that, you know, the partner complaining about the use of condoms, that was sort of an interference.
As I was thinking about women's roles, and especially being over 50 myself and with my own personal background, We didn't talk about sex, so I know it's kind of a taboo conversation. And so I'm going to just turn this this conversation over to our panelists because they are brilliant.
I think it's important just to mention issues and risks that lead us to engage in high-risk behavior. When we are lonely, we make choices that might not be in our best interest. And it's really important that we have a critical awareness of where we are in our center in terms of how we feel about ourselves. Social isolation. When we are withdrawn and we are not connected, we may make certain decisions that can impact our health and well-being. And also feelings of worthlessness, hopelessness, and again, low self-esteem. Authentic dialogue is critical in terms of our sexuality and sexual interaction. There's a tendency for us to deny us feeling desperate. There's nothing wrong with feeling desperate, but it's important to own your feelings of desperation so that you don't make those mistakes. Lastly, it's important to have sister circles. I believe in sister circles because it's important for us to continually dialogue. And thank you for allowing me to speak to you today.
Our next panelist is Ms. Claudia. That's my friend.
Good morning to all of you. As I listened, I thought about the fact that all of us at some point are involved in a faith-based group or church. And wouldn't it be wonderful if we could talk about these things that women need to talk about and to hear? But we also realize that our older members had questions, and we found that there were just basic information that people did not know. For example, look at this sheet that's part of your fact sheet. Look at the words that are at the top in the darker section. So many of our women were embarrassed or reluctant to say the words HIV, gonorrhea, herpes, crabs, intercourse, risk, chlamydia. And certainly they were reluctant to talk about protection. But more and more, as we continued our small group discussions, provided educational literature, we were now able to bring a testing unit to our church, but we found that we had to bring chairs outside adjacent to the testing unit because people wanted the information and they wanted to be tested. It's our responsibility to teach others, to teach our sisters, young ones, but particularly our older women, women over 50, to protect themselves, to learn about their bodies, to learn about their health, and to learn about the conditions that are affecting many of our seniors in their older years.
I started working at the THE clinic, and there was no program for women with HIV, and most of the doctors took care of men. So there was no real emphasis on looking at women and all of their needs in terms of HIV. And we were discovering. We didn't know much, but we were discovering and learning. So we started having groups with them. You talked about having sister circles. That was so critical because we had support groups for them, and they would come and they would cry and share because they had to go. A lot of these women were married. They had their children. So they had to go home and pretend like nothing happened, take care of the kids, took care of their man, as if they didn't have anything. Those women were discovering about how they were used and abused, and that they did not know themselves. So my whole thing is talking about STDs to all generations. Know all about this so that we can protect ourselves. I thank you.
Now, this is the most fun I've been in a long time. And we're gonna transition from this portion of our conference. We could all do academic things, but this is not about that. It's about the community that it was extracted from, and now how do we interact with it so that it can become a better community. So I'm gonna turn the program over to her at this point, and I wanna thank you for the privilege of being here.
HAAFII Union, you've been an amazing moderator and done such a wonderful job. I want to thank these ladies. Thank you, Ms. Whittington, Ms. Spears, and Ms. Thomas. This has been an amazing panel. Please give a round of applause to these women who took all four of these women to time out of their schedules to be here today, and this is really important. There's more of this needed.
I hope you think that you're something too.